Hope you had a good day today. We get to talk to Jeffrey Smith tonight. He has been beyond busy, and we're very glad that he's rested up. Hopefully he had a good vegan Thanksgiving and is feeling ready to go right back at it again. He is the man, of course, who is leading the charge, educating the world about the danger of GMOs, and without Jeffrey Smith, I don't know where we'd be. Hello, my friend. Welcome back.
Hello. Thank you so much. Yes, I've been kind of busy. I left my town in Iowa in mid-July, and
yes.
Between then and the election, I was home about 2 weeks. I've been traveling most of it in California. I visited you in Oregon when I was there, and I've been up in Washington and New York and D.C., but in about a week, I'll end my travels for the year.
You've put in your time and then some, and I guess hopefully your wife remembered you when you came home.
Well, I did get a chance to travel with her twice.
Good.
And because after, you know, we were away for so many weeks, it's good to recognize each other. Yeah.
The big question is California. Are you entertaining the idea that the election was somehow rigged, thrown? Obviously, it was influenced unfairly and unjustly. But do you think that there's, do you smell a rat?
Well, you know, I don't have any inside information on voter fraud in California. Obviously, there's been plenty of evidence of voter fraud in the recent U.S. history in a lot of different states and a lot of different campaigns. And I know some of the investigators, I thought it was quite interesting when it was determined that Mitt Romney's family owned some of the voting machines. I thought that was an odd irony that it should be so blatant. I don't know. I tell you this, though, that people should know clearly, if they don't already know, that the loss of Prop 37 was not a referendum on labeling of GMOs. It was a referendum on did people believe the disinformation of more than $1 million a day spent on painting
$1 million a day. Unbelievable. Wow.
And these guys, we know that they have been successful for 20 years thrusting false myths into the minds of the American public and have done so successfully. So it should come as no surprise that they would fight back with the thing that they do best, which is lying. And it was pretty obvious for those of us who had knowledge of the situation just how blatant and absolutely, ridiculously unethical lies. I mean, some of them were illegal.
Yep.
Some of them were like, you know, sending out a mailer quoting the FDA as being in favor of Prop 37, even though that was illegal and untrue.
It was
having someone claiming to be part of Stanford University, and then Stanford complained they had to take the TV commercial down, claiming that a dietitian's association was against Prop 37 when it wasn't true. So some of it was blatantly illegal, but then there was the basic myth. I don't know if you've covered this.
Let's do this. Go ahead, please. Yeah, I want everyone to be on the same page and not let this just fall away into the background. This is a very big issue.
So if you believed the commercials, which ran four times an hour, and also on radio, and also the mailers that came three at least statewide, then you would believe that Prop 37, the labeling bill, would cost you at least $400 a year extra in grocery bills, that it was designed by trial lawyers for the purpose of promoting shakedown lawsuits, that it would hurt small businesses and farmers, that it had was poorly written, and that it was filled with special interest exceptions. Now, none of those points are true. In reality, it was a very simple labeling bill, written well, which would not have cost farmers anything, which would not have hurt small businesses, and which would not have increased the bills, the grocery store.
Correct.
It was not written by lawyers, and it was specifically designed to avoid frivolous lawsuits. So it didn't matter what the truth was. It mattered who had the bigger megaphone. And I also think that the messaging that was put out there by the pro-Prop 37 folks who were in charge of spending the money wasn't as strong as it should have been. There was a sense by the committee, which I was not participating with, that simply the right to know was powerful enough. Now, we knew from Oregon in 2002 that they also reversed a 70-30 advantage at the beginning of the campaign so that the labeling bill lost 30-70. And it was based on these lies, the same kind of lies. And right to know was not robust enough, because right to know is like, you can get everyone shaking their head up and down. Yes, of course, we have the right to know what's in our food. But if people say, oh, it's the same kind of thing, it's going to cost you money, it's going to hurt farmers, it's going to raise prices, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, then it loses its significance.
Mm-hmm.
But what we did with the Institute is we decided to promote the messaging that we know was more effective in really drumming up ironclad support that was immune to the biotech lies. And so I gave about 50 talks in the state. We promoted a doctor's conference where I was there and Dr. Don Huber was there and Michael Antonio and Dr. Seralini from France.
Mm-hmm.
I will talk about his research a little later in the hour.
Mm-hmm.
We also organized outreach to health faith leaders. We have a new website called Faith and GMOs, where we have interviews. It sounds like a joke. A swami, a rabbi, and three priests walk into a video studio.
We got
them on video, and we have some materials, etc.
That is a great beginning to a joke. All right. Yeah.
I know. So we ended up. What happened was, Jeff, that at the end of the day, although we lost at the ballot box, there was a change, there was a sea change in the public awareness of GMOs. All of a sudden, we had actors and musicians and comedians jumping on board. Bill Maher had a show on it. I was on Dr. Oz a second time.
Uh-huh.
Danny DeVito, Dick Van Dyke, Chevy Chase, all these people came out of the woodwork saying they were in favor of labeling GMOs, and some very top musicians put things out. There was tons of videos circulating. We were sending out three a day by the last 2 weeks of the election, and it became cool to be against GMOs and certainly to be in favor of labeling. And I have traveled... I've been on this issue for 16 years, and I've traveled extensively around the United States for 9 or 10 years,
mm-hmm.
and I've never seen what I saw in the level of enthusiasm and commitment among the volunteers in California, such that from the very moment when they realized that we lost Prop 37,
uh-huh.
their next statement was, what's next? No one was willing to back down. And the level of commitment to non-GM eating has increased dramatically. Now, at the same time, Jeff, what my messaging has evolved, and I want to share this information with you, it's in relationship to both my film, Genetic Roulette, The Gamble of Our Lives,
mm-hmm.
as well as what I was soliciting specific responses from the audiences that I traveled through in California, and it's really a breakthrough. It's quite, quite interesting.
Okay,
let me
hold that thought. I'm going to go right through the break. Brett, thank you. I want to make one point. They announced in California the loss of Prop 37 at the polls when there were still almost 2 million votes to be counted.
Yes.
Unbelievable. I've never seen that before. The final count, yes, 5,749,000. No, 6,198,000. it lost 51.9% to 48.1%. Now, that's close enough. That's a margin of error, in my opinion, to easily throw an election. Easily. That's just my thought. Number two, you look at a map of all the counties for and against. The entire, obviously, the agrarian portion of the state, right down the San Joaquin, Sacramento valleys, and in the southeast and so forth, corner of the state, all voted, of course, no. This is not a surprise. But I don't, any time an election, Jeff, comes in 51-49, I don't buy it. And especially something like this when there is literally how many billions riding on this ultimately? Who knows? Who can count that high? I don't know. So I'm not convinced. Second thing I want to mention is, yes, the energy from the beginning of these people in California was special. Those supporting the measure. It was remarkable. I could see it on the internet. I could feel it in their writing. So bravo to all you folks in California. I don't think you lost. I really don't. I think you won. Maybe it was a Pyrrhic victory, but you won. And I think the door is wide open to do it again. And next time, flatten the opposition.